We're looking at a fossil of a dinosaur, a hadrosaur, a plant-eating dinosaur from Canada that we acquired. This is not the whole dinosaur, of course, it's just a part of it. It's the base of the tail, and you're looking at a dinosaur that was probably about 6 to 7 metres long and weighed about 3 tonne, so it's quite a big animal. What we're looking at here is the base of the tail. So just to my left there, you'll have the hip, and where the leg articulates into the hip, and this is the tail tip over this way, and this is the top of the animal here, and this is the bottom of the animal here. What we have here is a row of vertebrae, the backbone, running along here, and these are the splines that come out of the vertebra, and the muscles attached to the tips of these things. And right along here, this mass of material here is actually part of the skin, the outer skin of the hadrosaur, which is, it's not unique, but it's very rare to find mummified skin and skin impressions. And we have them both. We've got the real skin on top and we have the impressions underneath here. It's told us a lot about what these animals looked like in real life, which we can't get from just the normal bones, of course. And from this, we've learnt that hadrosaurs, at least, don't have scaly skin like a snake. They have a pebbly type of skin. Their skin is made up of different sizes of pebble-like bones all together. What's special about this particular specimen is that it's articulated, for a start. And articulated means that all the bones are in the position that they were in life. A lot of people think that that's how we find dinosaurs and fossilised animals, but it's the exception, not the rule. Most times, animals, after they've died, their bones are scattered by scavengers or by water. And to find a complete animal is very special.